we are doing wrong, part one. Adam, the first man that God created, sinned against God. As a result of Adam's sin, everyone born into this world is born a sinner, which is why Romans chapter 3 verse 23 says that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And since the reward for sin is death, according to Romans 6:23, every human being is doomed to perish in hell. However, God is good, and not wanting us to perish, he made provision for our salvation. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Many of us have accepted Jesus as personal Lord and Savior. We are born again and have a relationship with God. And one day, Jesus will come and take us to heaven and we will forever be with him. In the meantime, we are enjoying a lot of blessings. All that Jesus is works in our favor. For instance, he is the bread of life, fountain of living water, the way, the truth, the life, and the light of the world. He is also the good shepherd, intercessor, our helper, deliverer, teacher, and so much more. Now, there is one vital thing that is lacking in the lives of many Christians. 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 24 and 25. After this happened, King Ben-Hadad of Aram gathered all his army and went to surround and attack the city of Samaria. The soldiers would not let people bring food into the city, so there was a time of terrible hunger in Samaria. It was so bad in Samaria that a donkey's head was sold for 80 pieces of silver, and one pint of dove's dung sold for 5 pieces of silver. Things were so bad in Samaria at this time that some people even started killing and eating their own children. 2 Kings 6, 26 to 29. By the time God intervened, 4 lepers were the first to discover the deliverance and salvation that God had brought to his people. The easy-to-read version of 2 Kings 7, 8-11 says, when these lepers came to where the camp began, they went into one tent. They ate and drank. Then they carried silver, gold, and clothes out of the camp and hid them. Then they came back and entered another tent. They carried things out from this tent and went out and hid them. Then they said to each other, we are doing wrong. Today we have good news, but we are silent. If we wait until the sun comes up, we'll be punished. Now let's go and tell the people who live in the king's palace. So the lepers came and called to the gatekeepers of the city. They told the gatekeepers, we went to the Aramean camp, but we did not hear anyone. No one was there, but the horses and donkeys were still tied up, and the tents were still standing. Then the gatekeepers of the city shouted out and told the people in the king's palace. After they had enjoyed God's provision all alone for some time, these lepers realized that what they were doing was wrong. They reported to the king's household, and the provision was enjoyed by all, except the man who doubted God's word, 2 Kings chapter 7, verses 19 and 20. Sharing is one thing that is lacking in so many Christians today. Now, thank God we are born again and enjoying God's provision. However, there are still many people who are outside Christ. According to 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9, it is not God's will for anyone to perish. As a result, Jesus commanded those of us who are already in his fold to go everywhere in the world and preach the good news to everyone. Mark chapter 16 verse 15. God wants everyone to come in and enjoy the provision that he has made for all of us in Christ Jesus. We are to go and present to the world Jesus the Savior, lover of our souls, and so on. Invite everyone to come and enjoy Jesus with us. God expects every born again Christian to do the kind of thing that Andrew did in John chapter 1 verses 40 to 42. Andrew was Simon Peter's brother. Andrew was one of the two disciples who heard what John had said. He had also followed Jesus. The first thing Andrew did was to find his brother Simon. He told him, "We have found the Messiah." Messiah means Christ. And he brought Simon to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You will be called Cephas." Cephas means Peter or rock. That's the New International Reader's Version. John gave a testimony about Jesus. Andrew became a follower of Jesus because of John's testimony. Andrew decided not to be selfish, but to tell his brother about the Lord as well. We are doing wrong if we fail to invite our loved ones to Christ or pray for their salvation. John chapter 1, verses 43 to 46. The next day, Jesus decided to leave for Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Philip was from the town of Bethsaida. So were Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one that Moses wrote about in the law. The prophets also wrote about him. He is Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." "Nazareth, can anything good come from there?" Nathanael asked. "Come and see," said Philip. The Lord wants us to follow Philip's example and invite others to Jesus, including our co-workers, friends, neighbors, and so on. Any Christian who fails to do this is doing wrong. Paul said in Romans chapter 10, verse 1, "Brothers and sisters, with all my heart I long for the people of Israel to be saved. I pray to God for them." That's the New International Reader's Version. This should be the sincere desire and attitude of every believer concerning unsaved souls. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen.